So that was Syrinx by Claude Debussy, and it is for solo flute, and it's been transcribed for clarinet, and I'm playing it on bass clarinet, so whatever. But we're not actually going to talk about this piece per se. We're going to be talking about dynamic range today. What is dynamic range? Well, dynamic range is the difference between the softest you can play and the loudest that you can play. How do we know what is loud and what is soft? When someone tells you to play softer or when you want to play softer, you may be thinking that you're playing soft, and you might be playing soft, but you know, everybody's sort of evaluation of what soft and loud is different. Something that I think is deafeningly loud, you would be like, yeah, it's not that loud. Wouldn't it be great if there was one, like a yardstick of what's loud and what's not loud and what's sort of loud, what's really soft? Well, you know what? Fortunately, there is, and it's called decibels. And that's what this is right next to me, is a decibel meter. It's an app for the iPad. You can get it on iOS or Android. They are free. So what are decibels? dB. Decibel is a unit of measurement of volume. Okay, so normal conversational volume, when people are talking, that is sort of where it's comfortable to listen to and you're not covering your ears or anything like that, is in like the mid-60s to mid-70s, depending on how loud you talk. Now, the theoretical bottom of the decibel range is zero, and that probably doesn't exist anywhere except outer space. And certainly not on this planet. It is almost impossible to get zero decibels. Now, let's talk about our human voice and what is the dynamic range of my voice. If I were to talk really loudly, I'm at about 90 decibels. If I were to whisper really quietly, I'm in about 40 decibels or so. So that's the dynamic range of my voice. Whew, before I lose it, that is. Now, the dynamic range of the bass clarinet, I'm going to play as loud as I can with a nice sound. I don't want to be playing with gross sound. I'm sure I could actually talk louder than 90 decibels, but I'd be wrecking my voice. You don't want to be wrecking your instrument or your reed or anything like that. So, with a nice sound, here is how loud I play. I got to kind of pivot a little bit so I can see it. That's about 98. If you want to call that a nice sound, I don't know. Okay. So I think the loudest up that it was about 97, 98. And now for the softest I can play today on this reed. Okay. So that is my dynamic range from about 97 to, let's say, 40 decibels. So that's, what is that, a dynamic range of about 55, 58, 59, depending on the register that I'm playing. So that's my dynamic range. So now let's talk about, is a piano always a piano? Should I play the same number piano whenever I'm playing a piece of music? Well, that needs to be 47 decibels to 55 decibels as a piano. Well, actually, the answer to that is no. And here's why. Every room, every hall, every practice room, everywhere has a different noise floor. And what is a noise floor? A noise floor is the volume of the room and the ambient noise of the room. So in my house here, I have an air filter upstairs, which is making a little bit of noise. And the air sort of swishing around through my house is making a little bit of noise. And frankly, Brooklyn is making a little bit of noise. So if I were to stop talking, we would find out what the noise floor of this room is. So the noise floor of this room is 34 decibels. Now what that means is that if I were to play a note, and I don't think I could, but if I were to play a note softer than 34 decibels, you would not hear me because the sound, the air, the ambient noise of this room would cover me up. It would mask my sound. So I'm going to take this upstairs and I'm going to put this whole unit here by my air filter. And I will show you what the difference is when this is by something that's a little bit louder, to give you an example. Okay, so here I am upstairs, and this is an air filter that's blowing right now. Now, the ambient noise floor of this room is going to be louder because this air filter is making more noise. So let's see what the noise floor is of this room. It's about 47 or 48 decibels. That is a full 13 or 14 decibels louder than it was downstairs. Now, if you can recall, I think the softest that I was able to play on the bass clarinet downstairs was about 40 decibels. If I were to play 40 decibels up here, you wouldn't hear me because the volume of the ambient noise floor, in particular, this filter, is louder than I was playing. So why am I telling you this? I'm telling you this because while decibels are a fixed unit of measure, dynamics of the instrument are not. They are relative. So if you are in a quiet room and you want to play piano, you might be playing 40 or 45 or 50 decibels. But if you're in a concert hall where the noise floor is higher, that means that if you were to play the same piano or pianissimo there, you wouldn't hear yourself. Nobody would hear you because the hall is louder than you are. So this is important to know, that if you are going to get one of these decibel meters, and I think you should, to see what your dynamic range is, you have to understand that a piano downstairs is going to be different than a piano upstairs. And that's something to be aware of when you are in different environments playing. So if an orchestra conductor says, play piano, that's going to be a different piano than the piano that you play in your practice room. Okay, so that's just something to be aware of. All right, going back downstairs now. So your assignment for this week is this. Get this app. It's free. And what you're going to do is you're going to play as loud as you can and as quietly as you can. And what you're going to do is you're going to take those two numbers and subtract the small number from the big number. And that will give you your dynamic range. Again, my dynamic range was in the mid-50s to maybe, if I was lucky, 60. What is yours? Here's what you're going to do. You're going to write it in the comments and you're going to tell me what your dynamic range is. Now, the larger your dynamic range, that just means that you have a broader palette of sound colors and volumes to play from. That's going to help you in the long run play more expressively because the clarinet in particular has one of the largest dynamic ranges of any instrument in the orchestra. It's pretty cool that we have that capability, so you want to make the most of it, okay? That's what I got for you this week. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye.